side about how I've been doing this now for over 21 years. This place is the site of my favorite show that I've ever done. And it's a weird reason. I got here and my band didn't show up. I only had three guys. So they got stuck in Nashville.
I was here for that show.
I was here for that show.
I had two guys that made it. They were in a different city. It was my drummer. It was my keyboard player and me. We were like this country power trio. And I remember going out on stage and saying, you know, I got up this morning, got a phone call, and they said that they're going to have to cancel the show. And I told them, there's no way we're canceling the show. You've never seen the party in Dauphin. The crowd went crazy, and we had a really good time. So this song, I wrote this at about 22 years old and started making trips to Nashville. And there's this guy, his name is Mark P. Sanders, a great songwriter. He wrote Heads Carolina, Tails California. He wrote I Hope You Dance, a lot of hits. And we're writing at a place called Star Trek, one of the McIntyre's companies. And I walk in, I'm like the cocky new kid from Canada. I'm going to show him what I can do, you know. And every line I came up with, he's like, nah, that's not very good. And I'm like, come on, man. So he left for a minute to make a phone call. And I'm in there working away on the song. And I listened for a minute to realize that someone in the room next door, it sounded like they were playing the radio and it was getting louder and louder. And I'm thinking, how rude. Like, don't they know that Paul Brandt from Canada is here? Like, come on, you know. I was gonna reach over and knock on the wall to let them know to keep it down, and I listened a little bit more closely, and I realized it was actually Reba. She was in the room next door rehearsing. It would have been a horrible introduction, so I'm glad I didn't do it. But he came back in, and there's part of the song. It was he was singing it kind of like this. He's like, first time I looked into your eyes, I knew this moment. This moment would arrive. Hit the low note. He's like, dude, you can hit that note, you know? So he's like, let's put it in the song. So this song has now become the most played Canadian country song in history. And it sounds like I'm bragging, but my only contribution was one note. So it's not that one. It goes like this. got a new song that came out a little while ago. I had a great time writing this down in Nashville with some new friends that I just made, and they actually wrote on the next one that we have coming up. And Brad Randall snuck into the room and wrote that one with us too, and just did an amazing job. So I'm really excited for you guys to hear that. It's coming, I think, probably in about 3 weeks or so. It's called Bittersweet, so be watching for that one. This one, it's called All About Her. I've been having a lot of fun with it, Liz actually got to perform it with me the other night at the National Music Center. We had an event there in Calgary where they have the Canadian Country Music Hall of Fame and the music, Canadian Music Hall of Fame, Songwriters Hall of Fame, and I thought I'd kind of spoof her a little bit, so I rewrote the song. I don't know if it's appropriate or not, but it's all about me, can't live without me, don't know what you did. Get you a man as good looking and as handsome as this. Yeah, I'm the man of my dreams. And this song is all about me. She said go back to the old one, so this is that song. One morning, didn't know where I was. I get off the bus, and we were in Morris, at the Morris Stampede. And this older gentleman walks up, shakes my hand, he goes, "Hi, my name's Paul Brandt." And I'm like, "What?" You know, I'm waiting for the cameras, like, what's going on here? And he owns a trucking company called Paul Brandt Trucking. And they got about 85 trucks. And he said, "We want to drive you up to the stage. We're sponsoring the event." Well, we became such great friends with the family that they ended up becoming godparents for our kids.
Aww.
And when I needed trucks for the convoy video, they provided the trucks. And they still truck for us on the road. And so there's really a special connection for us to Manitoba. And they've always been a big part of our story. So I'll play a little bit of that one too.
Break 1-9 the season, brother.
Doug, you got a copy on me, Big Ben, come on.
Yeah, 10-4, Big Ben, for sure. By golly, it's clean. Clear the flag, man. Come on.
Hit Big Ben 4, man. Thank you guys.